So then I called Vince. I said, bro, I got broke a couple ribs screwing around. I said, I need a doctor in Toronto when I get there. He goes, oh, well, before you, you know, he called me Monster. Well, Monster, before you go to Toronto, I need you down in Miami tomorrow. I said, Miami? Why Miami? Well, The Rock wants to rehearse the match. I said, rehearse what? I've never rehearsed anything in my life. What are you talking about? Well, you know, we just want to make sure you can still go. I'm like, all right. So out of respect, I go down to Miami. They got this ring set up in this hot-ass warehouse. And thank God The Rock's dad was there, Rocky Johnson, who I traveled with. He's one of my guys, you know. And Pat Patterson was there. And so I got in the ring with The Rock out of respect. And I really hadn't seen The Rock since I threw my headband out and he caught it when he was a kid, you know.
That's crazy.
And so now we're in the ring and he's this major star. I got nothing but respect for him because he's really good in the ring, Bo. I watched him. He really has his shit together. So we get there and all of a sudden, you know, we're talking about, okay, we're going to lock up. And he's telling me. And he's got this whole thing in his head. We're going to lock up, go to the corner. You go to throw a punch, I'll duck, I'll block it, spit.
Wait, quickly. This is the first time you've ever been through a rehearsal like this.
Yes. In 30 years.
It's shocking. They told me this.
No, shocking's not the, because the way he was explaining the Rikishi match before too, he's like, all right, I told him, throw me off the buckle and chart. You told him in that moment.
Yes,
in the moment.
Yes, Mike. Yes, they call it on the spot. Yeah, the entire match.
It's how things used to be done, yeah?
How?
It's insane. I
was just lead the match, bro. I listen with my ears and my heart. I can hear what they want, you know. And so at the end of the day, The Rock's saying, okay, duck this punch, bang, bang, bang. Then get some heat on me, shut me down. The duck's clothesline, two drop kicks over the top, okay, pull me out. You know, run me in the pool. And he's telling me all this stuff. I'm like, I'm going, you got the whole match planned out? He goes, well, no. He goes, these are all the high spots and all the good stuff. I said, well, what if this doesn't work? And the people shit on it. Are we going to keep doing this? You know, he goes, oh, that'll be fine. This, that, and the other. Sitting in this 100-degree warehouse is Rocky Johnson, Rock's dad, going, Dwayne, listen to Hogan. Listen to Hogan. You know, and so Pat Patterson goes, all right, now we want you to go through the match. I said, no. I said, if I go through this match now, I'm going to get hurt. There's no way in hell I can wrestle with no people. I need 50, 60, 70,000 people. You know, I can't wrestle.
By the way, and this is still with your ribs.
Yeah, yeah, but I wasn't selling it, bro. You know, I was all gimmicked up and shit. I wasn't selling that shit. But anyway, so then we go to Toronto, right? We're in the dressing room. And I really don't even like to get dressed in the dressing room with the guy I'm wrestling, you know, because I want things to be organic. I want to be able to feel. I don't like sitting in the dressing room with the guy. Mm. It's just something about that. I just like my cooler full of beer, you know, have my few beers and stuff, and then I'm ready to go. And so
it's so old school, man. Refreshing.
And that beer for him, he is a real American.
Yeah.
Like I don't, if you ask like, bro, who is number one real American, Hulk Hogan's got to be.
Okay. So now I've tried to remember some of these things. Okay. And all of a sudden I go out to the ring. Now I've hit The Rock in the back of the head with a hammer, a ball peen hammer. I put him in an ambulance. I put chains around the ambulance. I've got in a semi. I ran the ambulance over with the semi. Vince is going, do it again. I run the ambulance over again with the semi. I thought for sure I pissed people off. You know, I tried to do whatever I could to get heat because I'm Hollywood Hogan.
Yeah.
You know, the bad guy. You know, yeah. Scott Hall, that bullshit. God bless you. But anyway, so now I come out to the ring at WrestleMania 18 and they cheer like crazy. I'm like, oh shit. We got a problem.
Yeah.
Now he comes out and they boo the piss out of him. And so we start the match like you want to do bang. And all of a sudden, as he's hitting me, they're just booing the shit out of him. Ugh. And then all of a sudden, thumb in the eye, throat, whatever. I said, slow down, brother.
Yeah.
So I said, take us a few minutes to get this back on track. So I started listening, you know, and we got it back on track. And but then once we got on track, man, he was perfect. He pivots, you know, and he makes the transitions and he knows placement, the timing, you know, the balance, everything he's got is spot on. So it was just like a pleasure to work with him. I wish we'd have never talked, you know, because we really didn't do any of that shit we talked about.
So he just went off.
Yeah.
Script.
So we just basically, and actually usually I call the match in the ring, but he was so good. He was talking to me too. You know, somebody's that good, I listen, brother, you know, because I can learn on the spot and they're really quick. But that's how it works. You know, you just got to, you know, you got, it's an art form, you know, and once you've, it's all instinct, you know, and it's heartfelt. And once you really figure it out and once you get out there, then you can call your own destiny. Then you can, you know, make your own, the right deal for yourself. You know, once you get to that place where you're a real attraction, sometimes you get bigger than the company, and that can be a problem.
Hey guys, if you like that clip, hit the subscribe button. And if you want to see more zany clips, click the video right here.